Hello children, in our last class we learnt about land transportation, that is going from one place to other by land with the help of roads or tracks. Today in this video we are going to learn about water transportation. Water transports are also used to carry people and goods from one place to other. So let's learn about different modes of water transport. Children, this is a rowboat. It is made up of wood. And as you can see, it has two oars, which helps the boat to move. It is used for shallow waters. This is a sailboat and it moves with the help of wind. This is called a motorboat. So children, see at the back of the boat, there is a motor. This is jet ski. Only one person or maximum two people can sit on jet ski. This is called yacht. So children, as you can see, it's just like a motor boat, but it has a small cabin inside. So people can live inside the cabin for many days, because it's just like a mini house on a boat. This is a hovercraft. As you can see, this is like a air bubble. So the boat can move on the water, and some areas which are muddy, it can also move on muddy waters. This is a cruise ship. It is very big. Cruise ship is just like a small city on a boat. It has everything inside. A mall, gymnasium, rooms, auditorium. Cruise ships are just like mini cities on a boat. This is a cargo ship. So children, as I told, that ships carry passengers and goods from one place to another. So this is cargo ship carries containers full of different things. It is the cheapest mode of transportation to carry things from one place to other. This is a warship. So children, like there are soldiers and army on the land, similarly on water, there are marine officers or navy officers who uses warships to protect our country from our enemies. Children, this is submarine. Submarine travel underwater, and it cannot be seen until it comes up. It is used for sea exploration, like by the people who explore underwater life. And it can also be used by our marine forces or navy officers to protect our country from enemies. So children, we learnt about water transportation, which helps people and goods to go from one place to other, whether it's small distance or long distance. So next time, we will learn about one more new mode of transportation. See you in the next class. Bye.